fairly standard fare for any of the one that I think the taste is. But it's got a push of some stuff that you can get in the other box. You guys have a push of stuff on that, but it's not that good. You guys have a touch of anything audio related at all? I use it. We don't have an LDI actually in the studio. We have auto tune. We have editor. We have waves. Yeah, I do like Melodyne. Melodyne is pretty good. I like Melodyne. Actually, my least favorite of all is actually the auto-tune can be transparent, but you can work with it a little bit directly. Because auto-tune is really good at the auto-tune effect. So the guitar is straight up mostly auto-tune. Then I can definitely put the auto-tune in that stuff. So that's a little auto-tune. Melodyne probably is maybe the best sound in and Melodyne also does some things that the others don't. I'm fairly hands-off with that sort of thing, generally, my opinion, so I don't know what it is, but I don't do a lot of, super complex things, usually it's more complex, orchestral, and jazz, I generally use pitch correction when it's necessary. And typically I'm lucky the hard side of it is good, so it's more of a thing like, oh, that was a great take, that's a new take, but one note is a range or this range, and I'm having trouble quite getting, and I'll just select that one portion and just process it. I don't know if you ever have auto-tune on track. software is just a tool. I like to think of the software or the MPC, whatever your sequencer is, when you do this kind of thing. That's your issue. I don't play guitar that well, but I play guitar that well. I don't play guitar that well. Jumping samples, but then we show another form of sampling. think also is Logic Stock Sounds. I do like Logic Sounds. It's one of my favorite things about Logic. Logic Sounds brings just the most sounds for your buck. It's only $200, which is fairly cheap compared to some of the other things. It's about $400. Ableton Live is starting at about $400, I believe. It's kind of expensive, but Logic has a lot of sounds. There's probably thousands. Ableton Live has a pretty unique workflow. It's not like really anything else. The closest I can place Ableton Live is maybe the closest thing to the workflow. There's really nothing quite like Ableton Live in the way the workflow works. And I really like it.